Ever wondered what's in the processed food that we eat? Well, I do constantly. Now, are they safe or will we have health repercussions? What are the ingredients used? Now, these are questions that actually should be extended to non-edible goods like shampoos, creams, lotions, and even lipstick. Now, ingredients and additives play an important role in ensuring food and non-food products are properly and safely preserved while making it flavorful and often attractive. More on the players in the ingredients industry in our next segment. Have a look.
Everyone, regardless of culture and belief, is entitled to food that is safe and not harmful to the body in any way. Thus, it is not surprising when, according to the Halal Toyiban concept, consumable food can be forbidden if found to have traces of banned or dangerous substances. One company that is promoting clean and quality halal ingredients and halal certified products with the consumers in mind is Pure Circle Malaysia.
Pure Circle is the leading producer of a natural high-intensity sweetener in the world. We have facilities operating in three continents. Our activities range from the breeding of proprietary varieties of stevia plant, producing stevia extract into high-intensity sweetener. For riboflavin A and SG95, the main ingredient is stevia extract. Stevia extract is produced from stevia leaves, from the plant stevia, and this is halal. And for sweeter, the main ingredients are starch and stevia extracts, so both are halal ingredients. The enabling aids include ethanol, water, and enzymes. These are all halal ingredients. With stevia, you can have a healthy lifestyle. You can avoid obesity and diabetes without foregoing sweetness in your food, drinks, and dessert. Because stevia can be up to 400 times sweeter than cane sugar, it is low calorie, diabetes friendly, and it doesn't raise the level of sugar in the blood. Stevia can be used with sugar in food and drinks. Stevia can also be blended with sugar to produce low-calorie sugar. The consumers have the right to demand the food and beverage manufacturers to use healthy ingredients as sweeteners in food and drinks. I think we consumers have to drive that change.
There has been tremendous effort from all sectors to educate consumers to make wise decisions of healthy ingredients when making purchases. Switching from animal saturated fats to polyunsaturated oils is one of the ways to maintain a healthy heart and reduce the incidence and mortality from coronary heart diseases. The Malaysian Palm Oil Council, or MPOC, is an advocate of healthy ingredients. Tan Sri Dr. Yusof Pasiron, the Chief Executive Officer of MPOC, on their mission to make palm oil as the product of choice.
MPOC stands for Malaysian Palm Oil Council. It is set up by the Malaysian palm oil industry to help promote applications of palm oil in different industries all over the world. Palm oil is a vegetable oil, and because the way it is produced from plants and not from animal sources, palm oil is naturally halal. This is a very important consideration for supplying the halal food industry, like frying operations and industrial catering requirements where fats and oils are required. Palm oil has a special version of vitamin E called trochotrienol, can actually help prevent stroke and can actually help preserve the brain cells. The neurons of the brain are preserved when in the presence of vitamin E from palm oil, the trochotrienol. Palm oil has many advantages over competing oils and fats. Animal fats are normally not genuinely halal in the sense that the source is often unknown. Palm oil is also naturally solidified without the need to add chemicals that would always be done with the other vegetable oils. And on top of it, coming from trees and being a vegetable raw material, it is truly a halal-based product.
With the advancement of technology, the halal food market has become increasingly sophisticated. Now, this development has made it to become important for food producers to make sure and to make known that all the ingredients are fully halal certified. Consumers too are more aware of their rights. They often question ingredients used for their products, whether face cream, for example, and also toothpaste and also mouthwash, whether it's permissible or halal, and often take preventive measures. In our last segment, the Halal Development Corporation will give their feedback on today's topic.
Ingredients of food products are subjected to increased scrutiny as products found to have pork extract, even the slightest amount, is deemed non-halal or haram for consumption. That is why it is of great importance that the ingredients label is clearly and strategically placed. It's the same with other non-food products.
Halal integrity basically is one of the strategic thrusts being identified by HDC. So this is through the Halal Standard Development, Research and Development, Consultancy, as well as increased awareness and skill development program. Consumer can raise their complaints or seek information basically to four main agencies. First is they can go to Halal Hub Division of JAKIM. They can visit their office in Cyberjaya, or they can log into their website that is www.halal.gov.my. The other one is they can also raise their complaints to state religious authorities. Besides that, also they can go to Ministry of Domestic Trade, Consumerism and Cooperative. And last but not least, to our own Halal Industry Development Corporation. They can call our call center that is at 1-800-880-555, or also can log on to our website that is www.htcglobal.com.
One of the best ways to obtain more current facts on the halal industry is from the internet. The internet is a perfect source for all sorts of information, and that includes on the topics surrounding halal. On the same note, the Halal Development Corporation, HDC, can be seen as an oasis of information on halal. Find out more of HDC's plan for the betterment of the local halal industry.
We divide our program into two program, which we call it flagship program, and the other one is touch point program. And new halal standard being developed, like the halal pharmaceutical, which is already went to the first draft. And also we do promote this halal standard being developed, the MS 1500. This is the halal food standard. MS 2200, the halal cosmetic standard. MS 2400, the halal logistics standard. And MS 1500, the management from Islamic perspective standard. We do believe we create halal awareness and also demand for halal product and services. Now that consumer wanted to conduct their programs only in halal certified hotel, and at the same time also we can see the increased number of halal certificate application, and also we can see the increased request for halal awareness program being conducted in school or university, and to the extent even the halal training module are now embedded in the university curriculum.
One company that is taking the opportunity of excelling in the halal industry is BioFact Life. BioFact Life Sindarian Berhad is formed to answer the call by the government and also the global biotechnology trends. The advancements of biotechnologies and manufacturing skills has resulted in BioLife's performance to soar. Mr. Vince Chua, the Chief Executive Officer of BioFact Life, comments on the company's performance.
BioFact Life was formed in 2005 to align with global biotechnology trend. BioFact Life specializes in herbal biotechnology. Our first project is to cultivate cordyceps. Actually, it is a type of fungus. It parasites on the caterpillar. So caterpillar is not halal. So it makes the cordyceps not halal. Advanced biotechnology to use our media to replace the caterpillar. So this is the advance of biotechnology, which can extend the quality of it, can improve the quality of the cordyceps as well, can extend the market to Muslim, even to vegetarian markets. So it used to be the cordyceps is non-halal, and now it's certified with halal. There are 1.9 billion population of the Muslim, covers 112 countries in the world today. So the market is very big and still growing very fast. I think the market is huge.
In today's episode, we've learned that there are clear guidelines when manufacturing halal-related products. Manufacturers have to make the extra mile and be informed fully with knowledge before embarking on any halal-related businesses, which in the end will only be for the better, for it will benefit everybody involved. We also hope that after the show today, you have a clearer understanding on the halal ingredients industry. Lazaris once said, "Nothing changes until you do." So let's make that positive change for the better. Goodbye, everybody, till I see you again. Goodbye. We'll be right back.